Bianca Turner and I'm a self-taught artist. However, I do have a degree in economics, and in fact, I have a PhD in international economic affairs. However, I became an artist. This is my passion. And doing something that I like, it makes me feel like I don't work one day in my life. I'm on a permanent holiday. I was an economist for many years, and I use art as a technique of relaxation. It helped me to remove the stress that I had throughout the day when I was managing a lot of people or I was working with a lot of data. It was excellent. My significant other introduced me to small art kit 25 years ago, just for fun. And as I said, it was a hobby at the beginning. Then later on, my significant other became my husband and my art became my full-time job. And now I don't even see it as a 9-to-5 job. It's my career, and it will be my career until the end of my life. 25 years ago, I started to experiment with art. I didn't know anything about different techniques. Being a self-taught artist for me was just relaxation. But at some point, after about 15 years, I started to have a large inventory of art. Well, the economist in me told me that I have to show this inventory to someone. I treated my art as a product. I decided to create my own website and I created my own marketing campaign. I put myself out there in the online art world. So galleries started to look at my art. They started to invite me to various festivals. And at the beginning, I never said no. I just wanted to be part of the artist community. And I love painting, and I was doing it more and more. That was the beginning of my artistic career. I can say that the credit for the start of my artistic career was my knowledge in marketing. Then, about 8 years ago, I decided to take time off from work. I did a few months of like paintings, exhibitions, traveling, going to international shows, and that was it. I was born in Romania and I immigrated here about 30 years ago. Recently, I went back to Romania. I was there with a program organized by a university. What was interesting was that I was not allowed to present my art because I do not have a degree in visual arts. Although I was able to present my book, which was about business of art, I was not allowed to participate in any exhibitions because the country has a particular law that doesn't allow any artist that is not a graduate of a visual art institute to be part of their artist association. So all I can say is that I was lucky with other countries. I showed my art in Europe, Asia, both Americas. I'm very proud by the fact that I was able to show at the Carousel du Louvre in Paris. I showed my art at various art festivals in Italy, Spain. Recently, I exhibited at the Tokyo Metropolitan Art Museum. Upcoming exhibition, it's at the Nagasaki Prefectural Museum, and it's making a bridge between United States and Japan, talking about peace and how important peace is in the world. In Los Angeles, I exhibited in Pomona at the Sassi Museum and in Torrance at the Torrance Museum. So I'm very proud about the fact that I was able to show my art to almost the entire world. I like to donate my art to help various charity organizations to raise funds. And sometimes I donate all of the proceeds because I think it's very important to give back to the community, especially with everything that's happening now in the world, with so many people that suffer due to the wars and the fact that they have to move from one side to another. And I feel that it's important for an artist to get involved. So when I came to United States, I was interested to find about every area, to read about the history of each city, especially because everything was so new for me. I grew up in a house that was almost 100 years old. So for me, everything being from Europe was a comparison with the year when my house was built. I started to look at various smaller cities around Los Angeles because I was interested to see where are the corporate offices of major industries. And I found out that Fontana is the place where a lot of headquarters for important corporations are here. Well, that means that it employs a lot of people. So I look at the numbers. I found out that Fontana is 111th city in the United States from the economic point of view. And I realized that, you know, the small communities will gentrify, they will grow, but they also need art. They need to be exposed to everything that's beautiful. People can't just work. They have to find a balance between work and private life. And in private life, they should just enjoy art, enjoy music. And that is my way of giving back to small communities, trying to show the public what matters. I want to make my art accessible to everyone. Sometimes people don't have the time to go to the museums, or they are so busy with their daily life. But if we bring the art to them, it's a way of educating the population, bringing a message, and that's very important for me, to bring a message back to the community. Conceptual art is the one that I create. It addresses societal issues, problems that we deal with in our daily lives, addresses issues like political issues, climate change, societal issues about how people interact with each other. And my art has a message. It either has a message as a collection, or it has a message as an individual piece. Also, every art piece has a title. The title in my art continues the art piece. As far as the styles that I use, I could say that I lean towards lyrical abstract. However, I like to put a lot of styles in one piece, like cubism or symbolism or pointillism. And that's because my challenge is AI. When we have various styles put together on one piece of art, AI is harder to copy us, and it's harder to steal from us. It's harder to be trained. So I am very passionate about this new challenge that we, the artists, have to deal with, AI. You will find that message in my collections called Deeper Than AI and also Back from the Future. For example, everyone thinks about the future being all with bots and a lot of technology and AI technology. Yes, that's here to stay, and it will happen in the future to be everywhere. But we as humans have to understand that only if we learn AI very well, we can become better, we can challenge AI, and we can be even more original with our work, with everything we do. Another collection, it's called Back from the Future. The way how I see the future is through the bioengineering idea. So instead of projecting all these bots, flying cars and all these things, I was thinking about all the improvements that we will have in the healthcare system, in medicine, and that it's good. So from that point of view, it's going to be okay. So that's my approach in Back from the Future. That particular piece is actually the largest one in the show. It's 48 by 48 inches, and it's called Can-Can, which is a French dance. It's a very colorful piece, but it's also very symmetrical. I put a lot of thought into creating that piece. It's a lot of geometry. And what was interesting about this piece is that at the beginning of 2023, AI and ChatGPT were not trained train with recognizing every artist's work. And later on, I had a solo exhibition at an art gallery in Los Angeles. And I wanted to see if the title of my work was recognized by AI. And actually, it was. AI used exactly the same colors that I used in my painting, but it was more abstract and less geometric than my work. So I was happy because AI couldn't copy the human artist, but I was also surprised by the fact that AI did something more abstract and an artist was able to create something very geometrical and I would say almost perfect. Of course, we are not perfect, but with just the naked eye, you can see it like very symmetrical. I wrote a book. It's called The Business of Art. The reason why I wrote the book is because I realized that a lot of artists were not trained in school, or the self-taught artists don't know where to find the information about how to promote your work. There are a lot of things that an artist needs in order to apply for an art show, as an artist statement, biography. That portfolio has to be created in some particular way. A lot of artists started to approach me and ask me for help, and I didn't want to be away from my art studio. So then I decided to write a simple, comprehensive guide to give them exactly what they need, how to promote their art on social media, what's the best social media channel for them to put their art, to be out there in the world, and to pretty much have the same way as I had in my artistic career. The book, it's on Amazon, and I was very pleased to hear from a lot of my students and other self-taught artists that I gave them hope. So everyone was thinking that, okay, so now what am I gonna do with my art? But my book just gives them hope. And the good thing is that it's in an audio format. I know that a lot of artists like to listen to music or podcasts while they paint. So I made it very simple and they can just understand the main points without using too much attention or taking them away from their studio. If you want to find me or visit my online gallery, you can go to biancaturner.art. There you can find everything about me. You can read my curriculum vitae. You can explore all of my collections. And you can find my book, The Business of Art. My Instagram profile is Bianca Turner Art, and everything is just one click away to take people exactly to the area that they want to explore, either my book or any of my arts.